Close to $1 million has been invested in one local city in hopes of bringing some business back to the small town. 4029 first told you about the city of Mulberry losing two gas stations and a grocery store in the last few months. The town has been struggling to keep the few businesses it has left. In our Project Economy coverage tonight, 4029's Joe Ellison tells us why a new water tower could help.
It's new to the city of Mulberry, this 500,000-gallon water tank. City officials hope it'll bring better water pressure to residents and bring in more business.
This is the fruition of a dream.
Mulberry's Mayor Betty Feller says she started working with governmental agencies in 2005 in hopes of securing funding for this water tower. In 2007, the town secured close to $1 million loan, and now the 500,000-gallon tank is complete. It's replacing this 50,000-gallon tank built in 1960.
It was in such bad shape, and it was just not feasible to repair it.
The tank isn't just a new addition to the town. For the mayor, it's hope.
Water is a precious commodity and getting more so. I'm hoping that there's industry out there that recognizes that.
With a lot of for lease signs around town, city officials hope the tank will attract more businesses like Airgas. It's one of the few still left.
Well, their product is made solely of water and air.
In the last few months, overdue taxes caused businesses to close.
Two convenience stores, the Dairy Dip, and then our grocery store has closed.
It may take 40 years to pay off the water tower, but city officials say if it attracts new businesses, they could pay it off sooner.
On Thursday, there will be a dedication ceremony right here in front of this tank. City officials want to show residents the new 50,000-gallon tank and dedicate it to the city. In Mulberry, I'm Joe Ellison, 4029 News.